When we take a photograph of an apple, the camera records the light that bounced off the apple and went to the camera's lens. But this only records a single perspective of the apple. That's why photographs look flat. If we want to do a little bit better, we could take two photographs next to each other and then send one of those images to one of your eyes and the other image to the other eye. This is how 3D movies work, and it gives them depth. But it still has a problem. You can't turn your head and get more perspectives on the apple. We can do better than this. Light is a wave. It's like a water wave, only water waves are made of water, and light waves are made of electric and magnetic fields. We can deflect a light wave by passing it through a diffraction grating. The finer the grating, the more the light wave is deflected. And we can combine a bunch of these diffraction gratings in order to shape a light wave however we want it to be shaped. That's exactly what a hologram is. It's a combination, a superposition of diffraction gratings that are designed to reconstruct the original light wave that bounced off of the apple. But how do we make this hologram? Well, the way to make the hologram is to take the light that's bouncing off the apple and mix it with a laser beam. Then they'll form an interference pattern, similar to when you drop two pebbles into a pond. The waves spread out, and when they meet each other, they form sort of a crosshatch pattern. We're going to take this crosshatch pattern, this light interference pattern, and we're going to put it in some photographic chemicals that will record it. That's how we make the hologram. Common examples of holograms include credit card security images and novelty items. But the word hologram is commonly misused to describe other things, such as lenticular images and Pepper's ghost. There's a lot of exciting research done on holograms. A really tricky but cool problem is to make a moving hologram that would be useful for displays like TVs and computer displays. Could also be useful for medicine if, for example, the doctor would be able to see a moving 3D image of your heart. It would help him or her diagnose you. Someday, we may even be able to tell Obi-wan Kenobi that he's our only hope.